Welcome to WUDR Cover News at 6. I'm Sarah Kaufman.
And I'm Colin McSweeney.
Here, our breaking story tonight, drug dealers on Powell Corner. We go to Nicolette to see what it's all about. Nicolette?
The commerce at Eastern Kentucky University increases after EKU administration allows and encourages students to buy drugs on campus. The Board of Regents met tonight and finalized their decision, which allows drug dealers to set up on Powell Corner and sell their products. The sale will begin starting Monday, February 21st, and will continue through the rest of the school year. Right now, the drug dealers have a supply of heroin, cocaine, crystal meth, and marijuana. They're hoping to have a supply of more prescription drugs following spring break, including Lortabs and OxyContin. That is all we have on this story for now. This is Nicolette Koontz.
Thanks, Nicolette.
We'll be back in a few minutes. Stay with us. We're WUDR Cover News. The BCM, or Baptist Campus Ministry Building, is home to many God-loving college students. There are BCM buildings on many different college campuses in the nation with one common goal, to grow with God and serve others. We would love for you to come and meet our family, including Director Minister John Barron. Baptist Campus Ministry, a place to belong.
Service. Sisterhood. Tradition. Come be a part of an organization that means more. Kappa Delta Tau is Eastern's oldest service sorority dedicated to helping EKU, Richmond, and the surrounding areas. Come out and see what sisterhood and service should be about. Kappa Delta Tau.
A glorified Vietnam veteran who defeated the entire Viet Cong Army in 1975 is now attending classes at Eastern Kentucky University.
Wow, that sounds like such a juicy story. Now we go to a reporter, Matt Finley, with that story.
Tonight we will take you inside the man, the myth, the legend, Carl Machismo. Legendary, renowned, mulleted. All words that could be used to describe Carl Machismo. Carl has gained fame with the new generation since his enrollment, recently appearing on hit dating show, Crazy Love. While Carl enjoyed his experience on the show, it was soured by crew member Paul Ramsey.
Touching my wife on the shoulders and telling her that she needed to be mic'd. I don't know what that's slang for, but I don't like it. And he better not see me alone in an alley anytime here soon, or I'll show him what it means to be mic'd.
While his transition from military to college life has been relatively smooth, there have been a few small issues for Carl to deal with.
To use the class, but right now I'm going to need it for my students.
Really? Really? You're going to need this class for your students?
Yeah.
Is that what you're telling me?
Yeah.
You know who I am? I'm Carl Machismo. When you were riding your tricycle, little kid, I was in the middle of the jungle, and I ran out of nachos. I told that in one interview, and I could not light my queso with my cigarette and eat it.
And while he's led an amazing life, he wishes to leave our viewers with these words of inspiration.
Well, to all you ladies out there, when you pass me, just look at it. Look at my mustache and my hair. Damn it, it's stylish. Please, please come visit me.
And now we will be back after the break.
The life of a college student means you're overworked, underpaid, and exhausted. The world around you becomes nothing more than a haze. If you ever want to make it through, you have to remember one thing. Sleep. Yeah, you know that thing your cat gets more of than you? Put down the book every once in a while. Take a break. And curl up in a nice warm bed. 6 to 8 hours every night will have you ready to party. I mean study, in no time. Rest up, EKU. It's going to be a crazy semester.
We've recently received letters from the Eastern Progress here on campus. They have sent us many different messages saying the director and staff working at WUDR Cover News has no reason being on television or the internet. Now, their jealousy at our superiority has no bounds, it seems, as they go on to say, and I quote, "The news you broadcast at Channel 6 is completely fabricated, fake, and fictional." Well, the official position here at WUDR Cover News is your mother.
Students at Eastern have experienced all different kinds of struggles with parking, or lack thereof. We investigated this audacity, and here's what we found.
Colin McSweeney reporting from the Alumni Coliseum parking lot. Now, it may seem a little desolate and a little empty this morning, but during the week around 8 a.m., it is pure pandemonium here in this parking lot. Pure viciousness takes place as the student body attempts to run each other over with their own vehicles.
It's terrible. It's too congested. You can't find a spot. Nowhere.
Now, we've went around campus to the different students to ask them why this is, and more importantly, what solutions they might have on a way to fix the parking problem here at Eastern. 62% of the students interviewed didn't think parking was a problem. Still, 36% of the interviewees didn't go to Eastern and didn't care. But two people said that Eastern should change things to make parking easier. So overall, it is obvious that students want things to change. Well, we have an expert here in the field of sociology, Dr. Philip Seymour Kaufman, who's going to shed some light on the subject.
That is Dr. Philip Seymour Kaufman.
Sir, you say that you have some insight as to why people seem to feel the need to lash out at each other in order to get a space.
Well, it all goes back to the wiring of the human mind. There are a set of tiers, if you will. I mention them in my book, The Tiered Theory of the Economical Mind. You see, the third, or maybe the third and a half tiered desire for mankind is the need for space. When a person feels their space is being invaded, they will go into a thing that we psychologists refer to as Raoul Rage. Now, Raoul Rage is when you have a neurological reaction in your nervous system. Oftentimes, people will exit their space and invade someone else's space with possibly a baseball bat or a 2x4 with nails.
Sir, I'm going to have to stop you there. Are you referring to road rage, possibly? Is that, or is that a different spelling?
No. It is Road Rage, named after Dr. Penelope Rage. God rest her soul.
Back to you at WUDR Cover News. Thanks, fellas. It seems that folks are all talking about it. Papa John is on campus.
And he seemed to be asking people at random what their favorite cheese was. And if they happened to guess his favorite cheese, they got 10 pounds of it.
Wow, that's great. I love cheese. In local news, Bobby Ray Wilkins, a farmer down in Scottsville, has told viewers that he has found the ninth wonder of the world. Amazingly enough, there is a shadowy portion near the end of his cornfield where the sun cannot and will not shine. Now, scientists are amazed by this, and they are looking forward to viewing the area year-round for further research. But Bobby did add one point to say, well, at least now, when my wife says, you can stick it where the sun don't shine, he'll know where to put it.
Valentine's Day, or as some people know it, Singles Awareness Day. Jamie reports on how people view this controversial day.
That's right. I am here on Eastern's campus talking to students about Valentine's Day. Will the day reign supreme as Valentine's Day, a day of love, adoration, and significant gain for the candy industry? Or a Singles Awareness Day, a day of pain, agony, and also significant gain for the candy industry. Here are the opinions of some of Eastern students.
Never had a girlfriend.
I love Valentine's Day because I love getting the flowers and the candy.
Valentine's Day gives me extremely bad diarrhea.
Valentine's Day is a suck-ass holiday and it's sexist. And I know I'm wearing a love shirt, but screw love.
International Nerd Day.
As you can tell, Eastern has a wide variety of Valentine's Day opinions, but I think it may need to be renamed Singles Awareness Day. I'm Jamie Ashton, reporting from EKU.
Oh yes, I've had my lonely days. They've been spent oh so sad. My boyfriend was taking me out to dinner, and I had found the ring in the drawer earlier. I was expecting to get proposed to, and I was just left there all alone.
Love on the rocks. She doesn't deserve it. She's a great anchor. So, whoever you are out there, watch out. I might pop you.
It was just an awful day.
Well, thank you very much for watching WUDR Cover News at 6. When it comes to news,
we've got you covered.